Hey guys, it's Claudia from Accelerate Off-Grid Touring here again with another 300 series. This one we have our under-bonnet dual battery kit that we've installed with the Invicta 100 amp battery. Before we get into this build, I've got Josh here. We get a couple of questions every now and again from people out on the road. Very minor fault finding things. One of the main questions is, what do we actually do if we drain this flat because we haven't been monitoring our app properly?
So if you drain the Invicta Lithium flat, completely fine, doesn't harm the battery as such. The battery is actually designed to go into a shutdown state if it goes past a certain point of charge. To do that, what that means is then we need to wake that battery back up for it to receive charge. Quite simple, a lot of the REDARC DC chargers, or basically all the DC-DC chargers as part of our kit, have a built-in wake-up function. So what that means is it pretty much outputs 12 volt power regardless if it sees the battery or not to wake it up. So you should just be able to start your car, and once the charger kind of kicks in, starts charging, it should wake your lithium battery up. In the case that the charger doesn't wake it up, which is very rare, but it does happen because the battery has gone past a certain point where the charger is not enough, it's essentially very similar to jump starting a flat car, like a flat start battery, a car that won't start. What the battery needs to see is just 12 volts across the top of the battery, be it from another car. The most common one that I suggest and have used myself is just a portable jump starter, like a lithium portable little jump starter. You just hook that on, pretty much give it 12 volts, start the car, and it should wake up and start charging. The key things you'll know when your lithium's flat, obviously number one, your beer will be warm and your fridge won't work, and you won't be able to see the battery on the app either. So if you can't connect to it, can't see it on the app, it's most likely because it's in a shutdown state.
Gone flat. Yep, cool. Easy, but easy enough to turn it back on again, which is really handy. Another question we get asked is, yes, my battery's got charged, but I'm not seeing any vehicle input through the app, or yep, maybe flashing lights on the REDARC charger. What's the first sort of thing that we would look for?
So the first things we look for, as always, with any fault finding under the sun, so we check the fuses. So right on top of the battery here on our kit, we've got some what they call MIDI fuses. So the first lot of MIDI fuses is our DC in and DC out. Now to explain that, DC is basically direct current, 12 volt. Our DC in is our vehicle input. So that's actually the charge from the start battery and the alternator to the REDARC charger. And then the output obviously is our output to the auxiliary battery to charge that. So there's two fuses on top of the battery here. We can just pop this cover open and pretty much test light or a multimeter, we can check either side or visually look at them as well. So they've got a clear top, and they're very obvious when they're blown, to be honest, that you see the blown burnt mark. If you're unsure, quick test light over each side will tell you what's going on.
And what do we call that type of fuse?
So this is a MIDI fuse. Reason we use MIDI fuses is they are a bolt-in style fuse, so they're a much better connection than your, for charge circuits anyway, than your standard blade styles, because blade style fuses, they get a bit of resistance in them and can melt quite easily.
Easy, and they're easily replaceable, aren't they?
Yep, it's so not too hard. To replace them, for convenience, they've got a Phillips head in the middle of them, or they are just a standard 8mm bolt. You just undo those, pop the fuse out, pop it back in, and away you go. Now, disclaimer with anything, as when replacing fuses, especially on the positive side, so the live side of the system, it's always best practice to disconnect the batteries just to avoid any arcing in as such.
Another question we get every now and again is, you know, I can see battery percentage on my app. However, when I'm plugging into the socket bank in the rear, my fridge, my lights, my phone isn't charging. Usually that is directly related to sometimes a fuse, and where would we find those fuses for the sockets in the rear?
Awesome. So again, on our top plate of our dual battery tray, we have our socket fuses towards the back. So we run two power supplies into the rear. The reason we split it into two supplies to our socket bank is so you can have a dedicated circuit for your fridge and a dedicated circuit for the USBs, the SIG sockets, kind of the other stuff. Reason being, if you were to loop them all into one fuse and you plug in your camp light it's 15 years old and it blows a fuse, again, we end up with warm fridges. So, it's pretty much the same as the DC in and DC out fuses. They are a MIDI style fuse. These two are both 30 amp circuits. And the exact same, we can flip the cover up, Again, with a Phillip head or an 8mm socket, swap those fuses out if they were to blow.
Another one is when these 300s are set up for towing, we run an isolated Anderson plug to the rear, being able to charge, you know, batteries in your caravan. Sometimes that might not have power to it. Again, can be fuse related, so where would those fuses be located on the kit?
So, surprise, surprise, on top of our dual battery tray. So we've made it very convenient as well. So if you opt for the towing setups as part of the kit, they're mounted on the top here in the middle. So we've got ISO, which is pretty much short and stands for our isolated Anderson plug circuit. So that's the Anderson plug at the tow bar to charge caravan. Other one up here is the ESC fuse. So that's your electronic stability control. Some caravans, their ESC powers up off the caravan batteries, some power up off the vehicle through a red Anderson plug. So I'll just recommend checking with your caravan manufacturer on that one before opting for ESC, because it's a bit all over the place depending on the van manufacturer. The other thing that is part of the towing setup is the circuit breaker for the REDARC Tow Pro Elite if you opt for that as well. That's actually located down on the side of the tray, so that's a 30 amp auto reset circuit breaker. The reason we use an auto reset circuit breaker on a Tow Pro and mount it on this kit is in the event there is an issue with the brakes, obviously that circuit breaker will tick off, and then after a period of time it will re-engage again. So even if there is a short or a reason, you know, that circuit breaker is faulting, you don't lose all of your brakes, because when you're towing a 3.5 ton van, that's the last thing you want. The last thing that is part of the towing kit as such is on the side of this tray, again, tucked out of the way, is our relay. So there's a 100 amp relay there that is triggered via the ignition circuit, and that just switches the isolated Anderson plug on the rear via ignition. So there's only power down there when the car's running.
Lovely. Awesome. So if you're having any of those troubles, I hope this video helps you out. Otherwise, you're more than welcome to get in touch and we can advise over the phone. Thank you so much, Josh, as always.
Always a pleasure.
So that is everything in the front of the car that we've done. So our under-bonnet 300 series kit. We're gonna pop around to the back of the car now, because that's where all our sockets are, and a really cool feature I wanna show you. All right, so we're in the back of this 300 now. This is where we mount our socket bank. So we've made a custom socket plate that we mount into the rear seat cup holder. And that's where we put all of our dual USBs and 12 volt cigarette sockets. This one, we've also got two Anderson outputs as well. So plugging anything from fridges to lights to mobile phones, charging cameras, everything like that. Super, super handy, easy to access, and really functional as well. So that really cool feature I mentioned before was, it's really simple, but really cool at the same time. So it's a tail light. So this one is a custom made one by JBA Fabrications. They're in Melbourne. We actually met them through RV Storage Solutions, the guys that do all of our draw systems for us. So he came in and saw us last year. We absolutely love this light, and we've done quite a few of them now, but haven't touched on it a lot. So it's a flush mount light. It sits completely flat, so when you close your tailgate, you can't knock it off, you can't damage it. The light itself is actually recessed into the plate, so it's really flush, really neat. It's a tri-colored light as well, so they provide this little dial, so it's an on off on dial. So one is a white light, it really helps light up the back of the vehicle. Then you also have your orange light, so when you're out camping, mosquitoes, stuff like that, they're not going to be attracted to this orange light, and your car isn't going to be invaded by bugs. So picked up on, loved, and now it's a common thing that we install in pretty much every 300 build. Another 300 series accessory that we, I guess, fell in love with again, like the light, is the advanced ice trailer bracket. It's now just a standard installation on any 300 series. It looks so much neater than doing your flat plate. This is, again, especially designed for the 300. There's a big mount sort of arm that sits up here. It's got your prefabricated was a connection mount. You got two holes here. That's for your airbags, your manual inflation valves. You've got space for up to three Anderson plugs. So if you do need another one, we can put it on there. Space for a 7 or a 12 pin trailer plug, and obviously a breakaway on there as well. It keeps it looking so neat and tidy, and much better than your old school flat plates. All right, so that's everything we've done so far on this car, but he's actually gonna be back in. We're doing advanced ICE head unit integration for his caravan cameras. We're going to be doing potentially getting him to J-Max for a bit of a lift and some new tires and rims. We'll be doing GME things, so he wants the full UHF with the sticky antenna and everything like that. He's also coming back in for our tow bar cutout service, so you can see on the back there, it looks really messy, and so he's gonna bring his cover back into us and we're gonna cut that out for him. And he might even be interested in some draw systems from RV as well, so you will see this car back in our workshop very soon. Thanks for watching another one of our run-throughs on these Epic 300s. We do quite a few of them now. If you're interested in one of these kits, you can purchase them off our website. If you want to watch our other recent builds up here, and YouTube thinks you should watch this one down here.
Accelerate off-grid touring, powering your adventures.